Media bias is unfortunately unavoidable. Every piece of news that you read, every piece of news that you consume is biased in one way or another. Ground News is the world's first news comparison platform that actually allows you to see how different outlets are spinning or even outright lying about different stories. Whether it's from the left, the right, or the center, Ground News allows you to see how each side is spinning it. Ground News is a free app available now in the Apple App Store, in the Google Play Store, and via your web browser. Or just click the link in the description below to get started. Folks, today's the day. The day we've been waiting for 4 years. You know, the shot at redemption here. It's election day. And hopefully, last time for the next few years, I actually have to talk about presidential polling. But one last time, as the voting begins officially on election day, let's talk about polling numbers. Right now, it is a complete crap show for Donald Trump. If you look at the polls, it would appear as if he has no path to victory whatsoever. Now, that's only if you base it on the polls, and obviously that is not what the final outcome is going to be. It is an indicator on where things are likely to go, but in no way tells us for sure what is going to happen. So keep that in mind as I talk about this. Again, this is not to say that Joe Biden has it in the bag or that Donald Trump has done. Absolutely not. Trump is very likely to win this thing, even with his trailing in literally every single poll. But here's a bit of good news as we go into this day awaiting the results. First and foremost, Joe Biden has a lead in four of the biggest battleground states: Arizona, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, and Florida. He has only a 3-point lead in Florida, which is within the 3.2 margin of error. So statistically, that one is basically a tie. Now, here's the thing about Florida. Trump can't win the election without Florida. Joe Biden can. So even if Florida goes red, Joe Biden still has a clear path to victory, assuming he does pick up those other states I mentioned, plus several others, of which he is also polling ahead at the moment. If he loses Florida, he has to get Pennsylvania. Trump, it looks like he's going to end up with Ohio. North Carolina is still a bit of a toss-up. Joe Biden would need that in his column in order to pull out a victory if he doesn't get Florida. But if Biden gets Florida, go ahead and go to bed early tonight. It's over. Done. And I seem to be one of the few people on the left that actually thinks that's possible. Also, one of the few people that's actually here in Florida. But that actually doesn't matter. I'm in a very red part of Florida. So what I see anecdotally would indicate a Trump victory. But when I'm looking at the polls in Florida, what we see here is that, yeah, there's been a lot of Republican turnout in the early voting. Donald Trump has also seen his numbers flip with elderly voters, most of whom registered Republicans, and they've turned out to vote, but they don't like Trump anymore. So when we look at just Democrats voting versus Republicans voting, sure, it would look like a lot of Republicans voted, which is why Miami-Dade's looking a little red, because people are freaking out like, oh my God, more Republicans than Democrats have voted. Yeah. But those are Republicans who don't necessarily like Donald Trump. So we have to keep that in mind too. Now, that's just the polling. That's what we know. And besides, Democrats in Florida do have a polling advantage still of well over 100,000 votes, more than enough to flip the election. So we'll see what happens. We got to wait and see. Today's going to be a lot of wait and see. Here's the problem. As I said, Joe Biden's got these leads. And if we went only by the polls, yeah, Joe Biden would win this thing. But it's not just the polls. It's the voter suppression. It's the voter intimidation. You know, it's the glitches that are going to start popping up all throughout the day. It's the long voting lines that some people simply cannot sit and wait in. There's going to be all manners and all forms of suppression across the country, and that is going to take a toll on voters. And it is going to influence this election. The extent to which, again, wait and see. But things look good right now for the anti-Trump crowd, and hopefully it stays that way throughout the day.